If user authentication was successful, production schedule will be downloaded into Excel. If quantity completed exceeds quantity scheduled, negative quantity will be displayed showing overproduction. Total open quantity for the dates before the first date of downloaded schedule will be displayed in the past due column. By clicking on Show Demand button, you will get an additional tab that will show you net requirements for all manufactured items that match selection criteria specified in the header. Net requirements are always adjusted for nettable quantity on hand. When calculating net required dates, Production Planner also takes into account safety time and manufacturing lead time. Click on Show Demand button also updates corresponding scheduling tab. It shows details of MRP planned production orders and color codes dates with potential shortages or overproduction. Planned orders generated by MRP will be displayed under schedule quantity for each item, so you can quickly see schedule increases proposed by MRP. Dates with projected negative inventory will be highlighted in yellow. Projected quantity on hand calculation takes into account currently scheduled quantities and MRP generated planned orders. All highlighted cells will have comments attached to them with details of projected quantity on hand. Production Planner also checks for overscheduled quantities for items with non-zero shelf life. If cumulative scheduled quantity exceeds cumulative net requirements, Production Planner will check item shelf life to identify expiration date. If there are no requirements for an item for more than a certain number of days before it expires, scheduled quantity is highlighted in blue. You can access it by clicking on MRP report button. Detailed MRP report will open in a pop-up window and will show you details, item details, quantity on hand, gross requirements, and projected receipts. Also allows you to review capacity requirements for existing and simulation schedules, which means you can check production capacity before even updating schedule in QED. There are two different capacity reports available in Production Planner: Work Center's Utilization Report and Production Line Utilization Report. Work Center Utilization Report can be generated by clicking on Work Center Utilization button. In this report, work center load for each item and operation is calculated based on standard item routing. Work center capacity is consumed by operations based on their start date and item sequence. Capacity shortages are shown in red, based on the projected capacity availability shown in the report. You can adjust production schedule. Production Planner also allows you to simulate schedule roll forward based on the available capacity. Use suggested quantities in the Work Center Utilization Report to adjust the scheduled accordingly. If you maintain production rates at the production line levels instead of work centers, then you will use Production Line Utilization Report. In Production Planner, available capacity is consumed based on production run date and production sequence. You can run different capacity requirements scenarios by changing item sequence in sequence column. You can upload updated schedule by clicking on the upload button.